हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग। टुडे वी शैल कंटिन्यू आवर जॉब, दैट इज टू एक्सप्लेन एंड एनालाइज द इम्पॉर्टेंट लाइन्स ऑफ द प्ले द मर्चेंट ऑफ वेनिस, विच इज रिटन बाय विलियम शेक्सपियर। टुडे वी शैल गो विद द लाइन्स which are from the scene 7 of act 2. What we have read till now is that the daughter of Shylock, Jessica, has run away, has eloped away with with Lorenzo, and Shylock is very angry and sad hearing this news. But now the scene shifts from Venice city to the city of Belmont. Now we come to the Belmont, where Portia is waiting for the suitors, the best suitors who will choose the right casket in order to marry her. So here in this scene we are shown the Prince of Morocco, who is observing, who is looking at the three caskets which have been set by Portia, and it is told him that if he chooses the right casket, he will find her portrait, Portia's portrait, in it. Therefore he reads the inscriptions which are written on these three caskets very carefully, and let me tell you what is written on these three caskets. The casket which is of gold, that is the golden casket, bears the motto, that is what is written on the golden casket is, "Who chooseth me shall gain what many men desire." This line, this motto has been written on the golden casket. And on the silver casket, "Who chooseth me shall get as much as he deserves." This is written on the silver. And on the lead casket, it contains the motto, "Who chooseth me must give and hazard all that he hath." So these three inscriptions were written on the golden, the silver, and the lead caskets respectively. And anyone who comes there in order to marry Portia has to go through this test, kind of examination, to choose the right casket. And which one is the right casket? The right casket has the portrait or the picture of Portia. So now let us go with the lines. Here the Prince of Morocco examines the casket, and then let us see how he decides his choice. So let us go with the text. "Is it like that lead contains her? 'Twere damnation to think so base a thought, it were too gross to rib her sheer cloth in the obscure grave. Or shall I think in silver she is immured, being 10 times undervalued to tried gold? O sinful thought, never so rich a gem was set in worse than gold." So this is the text. So the Prince of Morocco is inspecting, in order to decide which casket he has to choose. So finally choosing, as we know that he finally chooses the golden casket. So before choosing that gold casket, Morocco is once again examining all the inscriptions written on the three caskets. And he is also reviewing his own arguments in the reverse order, that this cannot take so, and this cannot take so, and this can take so and so. In this way, he is reviewing his own arguments in the reverse order. He asked himself, what he asked? When he looks at the leaden casket, he asks whether the leaden casket can contain the picture of so beautiful and accomplished lady as Portia. So he asked himself that the leaden casket cannot take the picture of Portia, because lead is far too gross. It is a heavy metal, and it cannot enclose her in the dark grave. So even in the dark grave, Portia cannot be put in the leaden cloth, or in the cloth that is made of so heavy, so gross a metal. Then he also says that it would also be unworthy to think about Portia that her picture should be in this casket, because that even the thinking about the leaden casket is just like to think about hell. So he decides that the picture of Portia cannot be put in the leaden caskets. Then he says, it's not at all likely that a saint like Portia should be contained in a bay sleeve, because it would be too mean to enclose her shroud, her sheer cloth, that is the shroud, in the darkness of the tomb. Then he comes to the silver casket, and he wonders if the silver casket contains Portia's picture. That is, the silver casket can never take the Portia's picture, because it is 10 times cheaper. Silver is 10 times cheaper than pure gold. And he says that Portia is more than the gold. So her picture cannot be placed in the silver casket. He says that Portia is like a rich gem, and a rich gem cannot be kept in a cheaper metal box. So in this way, he rejects both leaden as well as the silver caskets, and he examines and reviews whatever the inscriptions were written upon them. And therefore, in the last, he decides that it cannot be put in a box other than a box of gold. That is, the picture of, or the portrait of Portia can only be placed in the box of the gold. And finally, he decides the golden casket. But we see what he finds when he opens the golden caskets. He finds what is written there, and what he finds actually in that. All that glitters is not gold. So in the golden casket, when he opens it, he finds the inscription written that all that glitters is not gold. Adhart, जो चमकता है वो सारा सोना नहीं होता है. जो चीज़ चमकती है उसका मतलब ये नहीं है कि वो सोना ही हो. दिस इज़ वॉट द प्रिंस ऑफ मोरक्को गेट्स आफ्टर हैविंग चोजन द गोल्डन कास्केट. लेट अस गो विद द क्रिटिकल नोट. देर आर सम फ्रेजेस जस्ट लाइक टू रिप. To rip means to enclose. Sheer cloth means a cloth that is smeared with melted wax and used to cover a dead body to be buried in the grave. So that is called sheer cloth. Lead, we know, was a common material for coffins formerly, and obscure here means the dark. So this is what the explanation as well as the context and the critical note of these lines which have been taken from scene 7, act 2. Now come to the next lines. Next lines are again from the act 2, but the scene is different. The scene is here 9. Now, the Prince of Morocco had gone. Now comes the Prince of Aragon. Now, how he makes his choice and how he decides what he says and what he does, that is in this scene. And unfortunately, he also fails to choose the right casket. And Portia is waiting for the right person to choose the right casket. And perhaps we know that she is in love with Bassanio and she is waiting for Bassanio who will choose the right casket. Till now, let us go with these lines.